Yes.
So, we do vets, that's what we do, but I'm pretty sure you can do everything with FLM as well. So, this is our session on Fusion, okay? How many of you have used Fusion before?
One.
So my name's Mr. Dolles. I work at Eastwood High School, and I'm a robotics teacher at Eastwood High School. I'm also a robotics coach. And one of the softwares that we use there is Fusion. We use other ones, but Fusion is one of those that, I'm gonna be honest with you, anybody can use it, you know? And now, it's a short session, it's 25 minutes. It's, I can't teach you everything, right? But I wanted to give you an introduction, just so that you guys can be like, that's pretty cool, I'm gonna try it. That's my goal today, is to like, I think that's pretty cool, I can try that, I can do that. And hopefully you guys, girls, hopefully you girls will try it. It's not that hard. Now it is confusing at first, but if you just stick with it, after a while, like, this is easy. I'm gonna make it look easy right now, but you can do this, I promise. I have a bunch of girls that do it, guys do it. So when you compete, you have your engineering notebooks, right? This, later on downstairs, there's a bunch of trophies that we've won from Worlds. Those trophies, we won them because we have amazing cats. That's one. Now let me ask you the second part. I attribute all my awards to my girls team because they're the ones who do all the work. My guys are slackers. But my girls are the ones that have that nice handwriting, pay attention to the detail. And so, not all of them can, but those awards down there, if you get a chance to go see them, mainly because of my girls. I mean, the guys played a little role. All right, so before we started, if I am gonna go kind of quick, I'm just trying to get your attention. You can go to eastwoodrobotics.com, click on Grow Powered, and videos, there's a bunch of different sessions there. If you want to learn about, it's all, we do VEX, guys. I don't do FLM. But it's the same thing, it's just a different platform. But here's VEX, if you want to learn how to CAD, using, this is for elementary kids, but it's using Tinkercad. It's actually pretty nice too, there's a session on that. There's if you want to do metal, because I know you guys, maybe some of you do FTC maybe, or you're gonna do FTC. When you get to high school, you're gonna do VEX. So I think they do VEX at high school. We got a bunch of stuff on there, all right? And we have the one for Fusion, okay? This one walks you through the steps on how to download the software. As a student, you get a free version. And so you just have to go in, fill up a couple paperwork. I think they ask you for like a copy of your ID. I think, what else did they ask you for? Oh, you go on to Hack, and you give them a schedule. Print out your schedule, send them a schedule and your ID. You get access for it. This is like a $2,000 software, guys, that you guys can have for free. And then it's web-based. I'm on the web right now. I'm gonna show you how to do the web-based. You don't have to have like a CADI computer, you know what I mean? You wanna do it on your Chromebook? You can do it on your Chromebook. It's a little bit slower, a little bit, but it's still, you can do it. You can do it on your phone, I think. So this just came out last year because of COVID. They released it like right on time. I was able to CAD with my kids through Chromebooks. It was amazing. So always go here and it's just one of, it's my son actually. He does a little presentation on how to use Fusion. Okay, all right, let's get started. So I'm gonna have to skip a couple areas because you know we don't have time for that. But today I'm gonna show you how to build the SpeedBot. This is one of the robots that we're actually building here. I don't know if you guys are gonna go to that session or not, but we have this session where they're actually building it. It's called the SpeedBot because it's so quick. And it's so small that I can do it on CAD pretty quick too. But it's just the little instructions. And again, you can find these at vexiq.com. It just shows you how to build it. We're gonna build this guy right now. Try to at least. And so here we go. So I'm gonna click on, this is Fusion, okay? It's a CADing software. You have to go and download the parts. But once you do that, all the parts are gonna be in your computer, like in your, it's a cloud, this is all cloud-based too, it's pretty, I think it's amazing, man. You could do teams, like if like you two are on one team, you could both be CADing at the same time, through the web. It's like ridiculously amazing. It's crazy. Okay, so let me make this bigger because it is a little bit too small. Let me just hold on, guys. My display settings. Let's go 200.
I have a quick question.
Go ahead.
Is it free?
It is free.
Okay, cool.
It is free. I only use free stuff because.
Okay, good.
Yeah, we don't have money to be paying for stuff, right?
Exactly.
So yeah, it is free. So look, once you go in here and you create a folder, right, and you have to upload the parts that you can download. All these parts, you can download them from Autodesk Education. They're all there. It's a zip folder. That video that I'm talking about, it shows you how to do all this step by step. We don't have time right now, but you upload them and they're all right here. Look. And literally, guys, girls, sorry, I'm used to seeing guys. Girls, you just drag and drop. You just drag and drop. And that's all you do, all right? So we're going to build this guy. So I need to get, for sure, I need to get one of these beams, a 2x8, and I get a mortar. I'm gonna skip ahead a little bit. I need to get a standoff, that's 4, I need to get a shaft and a tire, right? And I'm gonna build this guy right here, all right? And then I'm gonna mirror it, and then I'll just have 2, right? I can copy paste it and mirror it, and I'll have 2, and then I'm almost done. So let's do this right away. So this is your space where you're gonna be building. You just try to find, now you do have to know the part numbers, which after a while you're like, oh, it's this one, it's that one. But they do have pictures here. I'm gonna guess, and I think it's gonna be this guy. All you do is check it out. Just drag. Oh, I forgot a step. Most important step. Before you start, you wanna save it. It doesn't let you do anything unless you save it. So I'm gonna save it. I'm gonna call it Crew Power, right? I think I have to call it 2 because I already created one. I was practicing last night. I haven't done Fusion in a while. So once you save your file right away, next thing you wanna do is you can drag and drop now. And so you just click on it. There it is. So I have this funny mouse and I don't know how to use it. It's an Apple. So this is not the right one. This is a 6. So I'm going to delete it right away. You just click on it. Now I'm just going to use my cursor. So let's try the next one, I guess. Oh, you guys have good internet, I promise. Let's try this one. So we're looking for an 8-hole. That's not it. You just click delete. That's one of the parts we need, right? So let's find the other one. We need a shaft and a standoff. So these are beams, and they're kind of small, but we'll find them. So these guys are just gotta wait for them to render. This is a standoff. These are the shorties. We need a 4. I think it was a 4. Shafts. The more parts you have on here, the longer it takes to render. When you guys do it, you won't have that many parts. Yes, ma'am.
Right corner, each part, it says V1. Is that
right there? It is. There's different versions. And think most of the Civi one, you can actually, if you go to the VEX website, there's actually a brand new set of parts that just came out, and they actually have all the parts. I just don't have them downloaded yet. But you can. But yes, there's different versions. Did you have a question? Because I have it there, no? All right, hold on, let me find now the standoff and then we're done. This is the guy that, I don't know if it's the mouse, guys. Gross. It's not the mouse. It's like the website or something. Here it is. This is the other one that we need. So there it is. All right. So now the next question is, how do we put this together, right? Because right now they're all loose. They're all over the place. It's called constrained. They're not constrained right now. They're just like, they're just there. So how do we constrain them? And this is the part where... This is the building part. This is where you're actually going to build like the actual robot. So there's a couple of ways, and Fusion's pretty cool because it allows you to do one step, and it's kind of smart. It kind of knows what you want to do. And so if we go to the directions right away, it needs one right here, it needs one over here, and then this guy goes in the middle. And I think they're all in the middle, and two, okay? So let's do that right away. So ready? You just go up here, and it says joints. Now, that's the assemble part. I don't know if you see how it says assemble there. We're going to assemble a robot. We're going to put it together. And so I'm going to click on joints. And there's a bunch of different ways to do this. But, you know, this is an introductory class. All you got to do is you go over here and you click on this circle right here. Let's see if I can make it bigger. See that circle? Little circle that pops up. It's literally telling you, hey, I want to connect this circle. I'm going to click on it like that. You see how it's a little center circle? I'm going to click on it. I'm going to say, hey, you know what? I need to connect that guy right here on this circle. And so then you see how that circle is highlighted. You just click there and then it moves it for you. Now it's not correct yet, right? Because it's kind of like overlapping. You see these little arrows? Where you want it. Put it right there. And boom, you got your first part in. And you're probably thinking, that's going to take forever. The first couple of times, it does take a while, but then after a while, you actually get so good at it. I wish I had a better mouse. And now, like, if I move this part, they move together because they've been constrained. I gave it a rule. I said, hey, this hole belongs to this hole. And I gave it a rule, and now they're going to stay together forever. But let me finish really quickly. So I'm going to make a copy of this one. Copy, Control C, Control V, push capture positions. Show the trick that Fusion does. It takes pictures for you. I mean, there's the other one. And the other one is not constrained, okay? So I got to constrain it as well. I'm just going to move it to the side over here. Push OK. And I'm going to go again, joint. And I want this circle right there, right? That one. And I'm going to put it where it goes this time. I want that guy to go right here, right, on this one. And you can zoom in if you can't see, you can just zoom in. That's a little too much, but then click right there, and it'll move it for you. And it'll put it exactly where it's at. Now it's crooked, it didn't do it right, so I'm gonna fix it right away. I'll push cancel, just so it puts it back, okay. I think I might have clicked on the wrong one on this guy. So I'm gonna go joint, it's right here. This circle. I want it to be like the center. Click on it, and turn this guy around. And I want it to go right here. Right there. And it should go straight down. So there you go. And then you push OK. Check it out, we're getting there, right? I got the shaft. I need to put the shaft in there too. So again, ready? Joint. And then you just click on the little center until you see that little. Want that center circle, because if you click like right here, that little dot is where it's going to connect.
I don't want that connect there. I want the center of this part. That one. I want that guy
to connect right in the middle, right? It was this one, right? Right there. And then, of course, we don't wire on that side, so I'm going to drag it over here, right? Over here this way. Need room for the motor, so I'm going to get there. Push OK. All right. We're getting there now. Let's see. Let me go back to our quick build right away. So look, there's this piece right here, right? So I go back. Okay. So now I need the other side, one of these, right? So I'm gonna double click on it. Control C, Control V. I got myself a second one. There it is. Push OK. I'm just gonna leave it there. It's not constrained yet. Remember, this one's all, since it has rules, it's all one piece now. This guy, I want it to be part of that, right? So I'm gonna join it. Now I don't have to do all three because as soon as I put it, it's gonna be good. So I'm gonna go click join it. Now the part that you click on is the one that moves. So I'm gonna move this guy. Okay, so I'm gonna click right here in this circle. That one. And I'm gonna click on this other one over here. I want it to connect to this one right here. Goes. And then push OK. Zoom out a little bit. And there you go. So now, if you were doing the engineering notebook, you would want to take a picture of this, right? You'd be like snip. I don't know if you guys want to snip. So if you go down here on the bottom, you just click snip or screenshot, right? And then you just push new. And if you're doing notebook, you'd be like, step one, yeah, put these guys together, right? And then put it in your notebook, print it or whatever. We're not done yet, right? So let's get the wheel, let's get the motor, and then all I'm gonna do is mirror it and create another one, copy, paste, mirror it, and then you have your two sides. And I don't know how long I've been talking, but questions? What do you think? Can you do this? This is what wins us awards, because we go to worlds and there's people with CADs, but not CADs as nice as ours. Yes, ma'am.
So you virtually build a robot, are you able to code it off of Fusion?
I wish.
That'd be awesome.
There is like two softwares that you can do that. We've done it before, but through like an animation process. One of the trophies down there is the animation award. We created a game. And for that one, it wasn't like direct programming, but we created the robots in CAD, and then we used an animation, and we told her, all right, these parts move like this, these parts move, and we created a game, and the parts would move. It was pretty cool. Oh man, that one was a nightmare. Okay, let me continue, but any other questions? I found the wheels. Go ahead.
So, is there like on the side, is there a search feature to find the parts easier, or?
I wish. You think I'm hiding out on you, or you think I'm keeping secrets from you? No, I mean, yeah, I wish. After a while, you know the parts, and you know where they're at. And I'm going to be honest with you, my internet, or the school internet, and my internet at home, is way fresher than this. I would have been done already, everything else. But I don't know why this thing's acting all silly. Okay, I'm gonna push there. I got the wheel. I'm gonna move this guy out of the way, right? Now the wheels and the rims are not together. I don't know if you can see that, right? So we gotta put them together. Same tool, right? We go to joint, let's put them together. And I'm just gonna click, I want the rim, this outer circle, this outer rim right here. That part, I want it to go right here. And so I'm gonna click right there, and put it together, push okay, and you got yourself your rim, right? Now, I gotta put this guy on that axle, right? Same thing, look, just click joint. I use another software called Inventor. I can't just click on one button. I have to tell it exactly what kind of joint it is or what kind of constraint. Fusion is smart enough to know, okay, this guy's trying to do this. And you can go in here and you can tell, hey, you know what, this one's a motion. I need to revolve. I can click on revolve and tell it it's gonna be a revolving one. So now I can go in here and click on the rim, click on this center piece right here. So I gotta make sure it's the center, that one. See how it, something's wrong. I don't know too much. right, so I'm gonna click revolve. I'm gonna click on this guy. I'm gonna go back to position. Now, if you do something a full-on robot on this, you will start lagging a little bit. This is a web-based program, and after you start moving so many parts, the internet starts like, hey, can slow down a little bit. So you can also have this program on your desktop or on your computer, and it's way faster because it's not on the internet. Yeah. But for Chrome app, and there it is. So there you go. So yeah, it turned. I don't know if you guys saw it turn. Can you show this to a judge? Guys, anybody's gonna be like, whoa, you know? Let me finish it right away. I'm not sure how it's for you. I'm being a little off. Hold on a minute. Push OK. To move. So I'm right clicking, should be a grounding button somewhere around here. Can you see it? There it is. Thank you. So now that piece is not going to move at all. But since I said the tire was a revolving object, check it out. I can click on it and I can move it. See it? I think it's good. Are you showing it to a judge? You know, these people have never seen stuff like this, you know? And so, you can also push play. Is the timer ready?
Okay.
Dang, that was fast. Mm-hmm. So look, you can push play and it does a little video for you. We'll do it again. Got you distracted. And it records all the little steps that you've done. Okay, you show it to a judge and they'll be like, wow, this is cool. And that's our secret. You look at those world, we got seven? All because of my girls.
I think eight.
And because we can CAD. And because we can do other stuff too, but free. And I never went to no lesson or nothing. I don't even know how I got started on this. I started with Inventor and then I went to Fusion. But you can do this, alright? And it'll, I promise you, I mean you guys are pretty good. You'll win even more, you know? Questions before we leave the timer now. But
what programs are these? I know there was these for robotics.com. What other websites?
So if you go to eastwoodrobotics.com, there's another video. That video, and you click on Fusion one, it'll tell you where to go. Step by step, how to download all the parts. Now you would have to find some for Lego, but I'm sure you can. I know Lego has them too. And if not, build your robot in Vex, and then just tell them, well, we couldn't do it on Lego, and then judges won't, they'll still be impressed, and the robot should still look pretty similar, you know what I mean? But it's Autodesk. It's Autodesk has everything, and then Vex has everything, and Autodesk is all the software I use. I use Inventor, Fusion, AutoCAD, it's all in there. And it's all free for students, you can get your own license. I have a teacher license too, so my computers are mine, but you can have your own. Your personal computer if you have one. Any more questions? Sure. And the website has a bunch of info. Just go there and check out the videos. They're like 20 minutes long. They're not too long either. This is one of the girl powers we had virtual because of COVID. All right, girls. Thank you. You sure time's up? Are we on a different schedule or we're good? All right. Thank you, girls. I think you have to go to your next session.